Ke rata dikgetho tsena tsa 2012 hobane tsona di re tliseditse kgotso.
Dikgetho ka botsona dintle.
Dikgetho ke a kgetha. Molemong wa gore dikgetho di pholose, di nthuse. Ee, jwale mo baleneng ke bona di sa nthuse.
Lying at the southern tip of Africa and completely landlocked by the Republic of South Africa is a sovereign country, the Kingdom of Lesotho. With a surface area of 30,000 square kilometers, it is home to 2 million people. Fondly known as the Kingdom in the Sky, Lesotho's lowest altitude of its mostly mountainous terrain is the highest in the world at 1,400 meters above sea level. Today a constitutional monarch, Lesotho was founded in the early 1800s by one of Southern Africa's most revered leaders, King Moshoeshoe I. Lesotho became a British protectorate from 1868 and it remained so for 100 years until young minds exposed to African Renaissance started probing the possibility of independence.
Asa mufumadi bantse ba ile mogene moholo wa Lesotho yena a sebetsa ka matona a muthusa ile mogena la bua Jonathane ile Patriki Mota ile le shobo go majaga ile nkwebe meche ya ba o fitla ntwene ya rona ya dipolitiki tsa mega e ne re batla gore re ipuse le se ke ra batla sa manyesima ha re nenze re le tlasa tshireletso ya manyesima Gale bora di politiki he ba tlamea ho kamfasa ya ba party tse tharo BNP a sale a bua BCP a sa mogehle MFP a sa makotoko
di kgetho tsa Lesotho di re galilo ba le tsona ka 1965 ha Lesotho le fumana boipuso tsa manyesimane prene re sebedisa mokgwa wa kgetha ona wa mabatu o re neng re o nka go manyesimane re tlile jalo ka tsona ga ba letse dingale 1970 re ntse re sebedisa mokgwa ona o
le ga o le jalo dipolitiki tsa nako eno di ne di bonala di itshetlele ka dikereke maramatlo freedom party e ne bonala e ratwa ke the Anglican Church Basotho National Party in a banala eratwa ki the Roman Catholic Church. Basulan Congress in a Congress party in a one ally ratwagi Lesotho Evangelical Church.
The head of that village in Zatswawa, then in the Zala Parliament, in the E. Gravel at Sazamishamanis money, the Leza Bunza Tegamelo Holo Basulan Congress party. And by those who are the head on the we push all while. Yaba Basutland National Party, Ixola Basutland Congress Party.
In Bagabata Behu, K65, sitting in Naza Mahutli, Adinyewe, Yaba Mahota, Akulakamahua, Zingante, Rilaga than 1970. Kansas Service of Hosana. Yaba de Ketuzino, Dicadel, Huali, Hosanese, Holadiaho.
Kwana mo mo ferpere e mo ferfero ka dilente
BCP re ga ene bona la le matla mona tlase ene tse ba hore tang ka mabato a mangata bona tlase mona me e bile tla wi fela BNP ya bontsha ka matla maholo hore ke bona ba tlowina dikgetho.
So now as it goes on, well, you know, in 65 66 the elections was not really welcome, but Chief Labua Jonathan won. 1970 again we have the suspension of the constitution.
Ka mao humo ila go bana go ya Basutle National Party e fele. Wa boela wa tshwara dikgetho hape. Metse o tsona di se ga bantsa petella di feletse. O ba itse na go e o ntse di tswela pele. Yaba muso teng wa di emisa me muso o ile wa etswa tlasa o ileng wa bitswa state of emergency maemo a akumatsi.
I received a telephone call from one of those men who Europeans who were with us the previous day. He said, "Vincent, I'm instructed to ask you to call diplomats on the phone and tell them to listen to Radio Lesotho at 3 o'clock. And the Prime Minister made the announcement, which he made that day. He has taken power that was it. He took power.
Wa fika wa hana no hamogena le ya bua a tsitlella gore o tla fika a thonya dithotsa MFP a thonya tsa BCP le tsa haetsa BNP ba ga a ema hona mo. Ke a o tla ba le parliament eno e thunzeng ke mogena le ya bua e le nyang ka dilemo tse 16 kapo 13.
Ya ba ga fita mo he ho fikile 1986 ha masole a ketela di amuso wa BCP wa BNP ka 1986
le ngore puso ya masole a ile nga bonala ane a ikenze bontshunya gare tabeng ya ho banke puso ke yone e bile nya wera ya tswala ho hore bona enze ile bona me bona ho no sna motho a tlenga ka ba peisang kgang bane ba sa bui ka o qekisa bane ba bua ka go phatlalatsa fela mme ba phatlalatsa e le bona fela ba hlometse o ile wa mamelwa taba eo ya gore jwale go khutlelwe tabeng ya gore go khutlelwa dikgethong tse na le bona leso
a nka nako nyana ka nnete wa lokiswa he o keteletse jwale re tlotla re fitlha go tsa 1993.
Ka 93 BCP ne ile ya hlolela dikgetho di mo ya wina mabato a ka ofela a neng a le 65 kana go eo mira ke na gele banka parlamente ga sena bahanyetsi ya ba ho itoseta bahanyetsi ka hara rona ke ka lebaka lena ile nyare haria ho ya qetellong ya parliament eno yaba re aroha
and a new party, the LCD, was born in parliament,
So that was within the ruling party. And there were the upheavals of following the 1993 elections. Following the 1998 elections, it was even worse.
Displeasure ignited a fury that literally lit up the country.
98
A
good start was made. Three political parties joined hands and sets outside the gates of the palace to try and make peace.
Ntho no ka nawe hakanyetsa ho ntwe ka 40% ya basuthu ba vote ka ndlo parliament. Bana ba ba ka etsa ntwe ka 60% ba le ka parliament. Taba eno ile ba ka me fere fere le suthu mona tla ho bole ga ba ngile sata ke ketela etla ka sesole.
98 was also a very unfortunate period for the country, because the people who came to Lesotho to help, and I think genuinely they wanted to help, did things which made us extremely unhappy. Interim political authority was set up, and the political parties, all political parties, were brought together to work out something that would help Lesotho.
We had to start afresh with registration, because the political parties were not happy with the voters' roll that had been used in the elections. And so we started there, but even there, the design of the registration method, we did using participatory methods.
We learned not to fight, but to talk.
I also have a very strong feeling that the various complaints that were raised about the database of electors was correct. In fact, that consultancies, as I said earlier, of experts on these issues had said the database was faulty. That database should be abandoned and a new database built, so that when we go to the next election, 5 years down the line, we have a database that is clean and free of any kind of blame from anyone. A database that will, in truth, prove to be a database that reflects the population situation in Lesotho.
As I was a chairperson of the group that had gone through, the political parties that had gone through the palace, we had set up our very first meeting, I asked them, I said, friends, what are we going to say to the talks? Are there ideas that we are going to sell? They said, no, we really thought of nothing. I said, look, let me tell you, I am going to introduce a mixed member proportional model. I knew about it. I'd read about it, I had documents about it, and they said, okay, that's fine. And we did this. And that organization came with the mixed member proportional model. This has made a parliament which, for as long as we have it, we will never have one single party ruling, because a single party running a country is similar to a dictatorship.
In Rwanda, they have a constitution that even if the party wins outright majority or have a landslide, but in cabinet, they cannot have that party that has won a landslide, that has the majority. It cannot have more than 50% of ministerial positions.
We can see that since then, even though there will be queries here and there, elections have been relatively peaceful. And even though queries are there, there are systems for dealing with them.
After some time in 2002, political parties went for elections and they came back. There was more than four political parties in parliament. And things began to change for the better.
Ntho motho sa tsana langwe se ya ke gola go supa. Ho bona itse hanga da ka ya tamela difeto. Ho ba le mefirifiri ka ga di party bileng etsang hore dibedi ya go hwa. Ha ho lolo e bona itse di party tse buisang ha e sa le etsa la go 93 kamora dikgetho tsa 93 ya ga tla go tsa 98. PCPC ile ka bolela go ile a gwana ba LCD. Ha re tla ho tsena tsa 2002 ke re bile tsona di ntle ya di ha ho lolo bona di tse re tliseditseng kgotso. LPC ya beta wa ka ga LCD ene nye buisa. Le ha re se re tla ho tsena tsa 2007 pele re tla ho tsona. Re tla hopola go ile a ba le lengalo la NIPI le LCD. Go re National Independence Party le Lesotho Congress for Democracy. Kwa ba ha ba le lengalo la ABC ene ke ta ho thewa ka bo go bua ga tla re le di kgetho. ABC ya be se tsa le nyalo le yona le Lesotho Workers Party. Ha o so di shebisi ya taba tseno fumana wa. Manyalo ane ni mogago ene hlile go fela tshe di party tsa di mpe di fumanele di dulo tsa ne tsa gagetha.
Going to the elections in 2002, we actually had a split, if you recall, in the LCD. So we didn't get any PR seats. And that caused a lot of dissatisfaction on the part of our people in the party. Yes. So that is why now in going for 2007, we were mandated by the conference to find ways and means by which we could access the 40 PR seats. And that is how we came up with the idea of an alliance between ourselves, the LCD, and the National Independent Party.
Kana go ye no ka kotlo ba bohanyetsi ho nona le dintla tse mmalwa tse ba neng ba belaela ka tsona. Taba e kgolo ba ne ba re ditulo tseo lekgotla la eso leo ka jeno ke le eteletseng pele empa le neng le eteletswe pele ke ntate Bakadithamosisidi ka nako eno le batswile tlase ka gore ebe le ile la theya selekane le lekgotla la NIP ka nako eno, mme NIP ya ba e fumana ditulo tseo go ja go no sena lenyalo la mofuta o jalo e ka ba sakang ya di fumana, mme ditulo tseno ka ba ile tsa arolelanwa ke mega ya bohanyetsi.
Lekgetho la pele sataka ya ka ba yatlhe ya go gaolela Basotho mathata. Ile a ba Basotho ka bo bona sataka e se tlose ha ba kopana ka ketapele ya dikereke le mekgatlho e ikemetseng tse ileng tsa etsa gore go ketelele go fumaneya tharollo le ha tharollo e sa ka yatla ka tsela eo ba bamane ba ne ba lebeletse ka teng gagololo ba ne ba le ka opposition.
An interesting thing happened in parliament. We had suggested all sorts of reforms, such as coming together as three political parties, for example, BNP, MFP, ABC got together, and we elected a leader, our own leader, leader of opposition, and proposed the present prime minister to be our leader.
The unfortunate thing about that proposal was that it was made from the floor of the house. They rose on a point of order in the house. And then the speaker had to rule on that point of order. And she ruled that their alliance was not lawful. So Ndatetabane could not become the official leader of opposition.
Empa ya ba jwale ba sotho ka bo bona ka ba etapela ba dikereke di hlo tsa dikereke ka gona ha ena ya ba bakena gabong ile ka bo bona ho leka ho tlisa kutlisano mahlakogangana mme taba eno ya bona ya ba yona yo bona ka nete e tswala mamellano pakeng tsa mahlakoge ana ohle mamellano eno ke yona e linya ba ya qetella ge dumellana jwale ho gona gerare ya dikgethong tse hlahlamang ge sebetseng jwang ha e le mona go na le ba belaelang gore ga o wa sebetswa gantle ba bang ba ne ba belaela gore ga o wa sebetswa gantle e leng ba bohanyetsing ba ba pusong ba bona bona ba dumelelana le magotla gore ga ona mo go lobilweng molaoteng jale ya bataba ko gona go aga malwa pele jwang gore ditletlebo tse teng na ka molao di ka sebetswa jwang.
It's important to know that we as the UNDP embarked on a two-pronged strategy in addressing the elections challenges to build the capacity of the IEC. We had this post-2007 elections problems that were not yet resolved. Talks broke down between the government and opposition parties. And as a result, opposition parties decided to go on the street to protest. And the mood on the street was very ugly.
That effort of bringing parties consistently together has been the core of success. It's because even when they came together, the question was, what is it that they were going to discuss? Because government was very much convinced that it will never say anything. It will never engage in any discussion that would undermine what the court of law has already said. And we agreed that the church could lead the process. And when we consulted with politicians, they also agreed that the church could be the convener. Hence, the heads of churches were given that responsibility to lead the process, while civil society remained on site as the technical team.
If we do not put God in our agenda so that our agenda does not only become our agenda but God's agenda, we might be terribly disappointed when that day comes.
Re kene jwale rona mo ka kopo ya boga dipolitiki ka mo ga gore ya neng a rumilwe ke sadaka e leng ntate Kitumile Masire e neng e le mopresidente wa mehleng wa Botswana jwale o bonala a sa utlwane ho hang ho sena tumelano pakeng tsae le mmuso wa Lesotho ho sena tumelano pakeng tsae le bohanyetsi bo ne bo le teng manako eo go dima ditaba tseo tsa kabo ya ditulo gore na e tlileng ke loketsetsweng gore e be moetapele wa bohanyetsi ka lekgotleng la dipuisano tsa setšhaba ke mang ka paramenteng jale ya bogago le taba ya melao e amanang le dikgetho e ne e le ntlha tsena tse tharo tse kgolo tseo e ne e le tsona tse ne di tsekwa.
Taba ya ntho e bitswang dialogo le gore dipuisano di ntshetswe pele ka gagona ke ntho e motho e mong le mong ya phelang gantle a e labalabelang. Empa taba ya rona e feta moo. Taba ya rona ke gore ditulo tsane tse ka paramenteng di tshwanetse di lokiswe hanghang. Jwale ka morago go moo re tsebe go sebetsa re phuthuloile toka e entswe ka kabo ya ya ditulo ka parliamente.
The bishop was around, I think, but he was not actually in that meeting. Questions were being asked there. One of the questions that was being asked was, how is it that you, Mr. Prime Minister, you've packed yourself up with so many soldiers, you've got vehicles following you all over with fiercely armed soldiers. How is this happening? What is it that you are afraid of that you are so heavily armed? What is happening? What's going to happen to us with those arms of yours? Are you going to attack us? Because we are not intended to do this.
And when Dade Malebo, what's the word I want to use? When he really made fun of that situation, not taking it seriously at all, asking why has your security been beefed up, I took offense, because here was a very senior person, a leader of a party, who was questioning why the Prime Minister's security had been beefed up. And I had to indicate that you forget conveniently that my vehicles were stoned by your own people.
And then he got very furious. Then I'm not sure whether it was yours truly or it was himself who called out that the two of us must go out and fight it out outside, away from the meeting, because the young man who is now leader of BNP rose. He said, "Oh, please, gentlemen, it should never be done this way. This is not good." And then the Archbishop, Archbishop Lerotoni, also rose. He raised his hands. He said, "Please, gentlemen, don't do this. This is not a good thing to do. Don't do it." Of course, I sat there calmly because I found somebody was really smarting with pain.
The dialogue was not what it was thought it would be. We thought it would be once-off thing and be completed. But it turned out to be a built-up process towards 2012 itself, because parties began to agree on the changes that were needed to be done. We saw the IEC also determined to engage civil society to promote electoral education. We also saw IEC highly involving political parties, coming up with conflict resolution mechanisms. The tribunal, which was very popular in terms of addressing immediate conflicts that were arising. And it will look like when we went for 2012, almost all sectors of society were up and ready for elections. I mean, we saw the heads of churches continuing with a moral courage throughout the process, bringing political parties together, leaders together for joint prayer sessions, for joint agreements, and almost every other sector was involved, and it is not surprising that the 2012 outcome was the way it was.
Dikgethong tsena tsa 2012, ke gola kabelo e kgolo ya rona ile ya ba ka taba ya civic education and voter education. Again, it was part of the participation that we've always had, of observing, being part of the national observer groups that observe the election and monitor the processes, including registration, including the conduct of the poll itself, campaigning, counting, and the announcement.
Di kgethong tsena tse sa tswa feta, bophatlalatsi bo bapetse karolo e kgolo ka mekgatlholo e fapakaneng. re bona ho phatlalatse bo ruta setšhaba ka bohlokwa ba ho kgetha re bona ho phatlalatse bo ruta setšhaba ka bohlokwa ba ho nka karolo ditabeng tsa setšhaba ho ba le thahasello ditabeng tseo mekga dipolotiki e di etsang e le boithukiso ba dikgetho.
As back the 1960s, when Lesotho first had its first democratic elections, there were no women at all in the political arena. But that picture has changed as far as the 2012 elections are concerned. In the 2007 elections, we had an outcome of about 27% women who were elected democratically.
When we amended the Electoral Act, which is the basis for providing free fair elections, because of the engagement and consultative process we had, we got the dimension of gender right through the PR component of our mixed member proportional system.
And when we connect that to the outcomes of the 2012 National Assembly elections, we observe that out of the PR seats, we have about 45% women that came out as a result of that. While in the first past the post, we only have around 22 or so percent. So it means that this is an initiative step that Lesotho has adopted to ensure that women are elected.
Ma chabalona la ikena kame khatu ya bona obane ke bona hangata ba fanang ka chelete ha u dikhetho.
We at NISA, being an advocacy organization, felt compelled to participate in this election. And we approached the UNDP way back, even before the elections. Our first interaction with UNDP was when we hold a media training on elections, which was held in partnership with the Electoral Institute, the Electoral Commission, Independent Commission of Lesotho.
We could not have done this without the support of our partners, UNDPs, the European Union, the Irish Aid, and of course, the moral support of churches, of the group of churches like Christian Council of Lesotho.
No, I sincerely would want to acknowledge that the UN, I would say the UN staff as a whole, for making it easier for us to use the hall for these meetings. So that's where what I would call a direct engagement with the political leaders began at the UN House.
It would be remiss of me if, you know, if one cannot, from the bottom of his heart, express the sincere gratitude to the international organizations who have made our dialogue possible. In particular, all our cooperating partners. They have done a sterling job. UNDP, Commonwealth, Irish Aid, the list is too long, but would like to acknowledge the role that they have played and the role that they are continuing to play.
Following the deployment of the needs assessment mission in 2010, we worked closely with our colleagues in New York and the Regional Service Center for UNDP and the IEC to develop an election support plan. UNDP organized a meeting for development partners to come and discuss ways of supporting the IEC. During that meeting is where the IEC presented an election support plan.
It's also important to note that no development partner can do this alone. So we are working with our partners, and in this program, it was extremely important to enjoy the support of the Irish Aid, the United States Embassy in Maseru, and the USAID, which contributed significantly to the success of our achievements.
Our observation, our joint observation on the process, led to some improvements that the IEC could make in preparing for the general election. So I saw that as a very first important step leading up to what happened in May 2012.
One of the things that we look at in advance of an electoral period is ways that we can provide some kind of support. We were able to provide assistance through the United Nations Development Program for voter education and outreach in the period leading up to the election. We also paid close attention to the political process, particularly the period leading up to the dissolution of the parliament in 2012. And we were in regular contact with political leaders in the period beforehand, and in particular in the period leading up to the election, making known our interest in seeing Lesotho have free, fair, and transparent elections.
The preparation of May 26, 2012 elections started with the resuscitation of political party committees. Here in IEC, we believe that elections are too important to be left to IEC alone. So what we normally do is that we have established several committees composed by political parties and other interested stakeholders to monitor the election process.
In terms of managing the electoral atmosphere, it is very important that you engage and consult continuously with political parties, because they are the competitors. So if there is no efficiency in the organizations, definitely you will hear a lot of complaints. Come election day, all that was history for us. And I think because we were listening, because we were working very hard to improve upon the weaknesses, we had the kind of election we had in 2012.
One of the reasons why the local mediation worked is because this was led by people who understood the context of the country, the people of this country, the culture and how politics work. And that's why it's ultimately so important for UNDP and the international community to provide support to these leaders, because they are here to stay and they can also support the results of the elections way beyond election day.
Boemo ba dipolitiki bo ne bo rena ke hore re tlameha go no sontse o bona ha motho o sheba hore re ya dikgethong ke tshwagane ka matso ge le mega ge le basotho hore a e kanete phetwa yona e tlameha go bateng kanete letsatsi la dikgetho la ba letsatsi la dikgetho tse ileng tsa re tswalla namanena eo re reng ke ntho e ntsha yo re qalang ho e bona ka hara na le sotho le leng mmuso wa kopanelo.
Just before the elections, there had been a breakup in the ruling party.
Lekgotla la heso le ile la aroa ya ba ho ba le party e ntjha e thewang e leng party ya DC kajeno. Mme ya ba ha DC qeta ho aroa e tloha ho rona, ke moo ditho tsa lekgotla la heso la puso ya setšhaba ka setšhaba di leng tsangkhetha hore ke be moetapele wa lekgotla le la heso.
2011 again in the run up to 2012, now it was even worse. When now, it was not very clear as to whether people were crossing the floor, the role played by the speaker there, allowing DC to come to become government, people began to be suspicious. Maybe rightly or wrongly, because you see, she was a member of the LCD and crossed with the, should have crossed with the DC, could have been taken to have crossed with the DC. The speaker wouldn't have to cross the floor, in my view. The speaker would have to be politically neutral.
I'm going to go to the house. 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 I'm going to go to the
The formation of the DC was actually a very momentous occasion, even in terms of the politics of Lesotho generally, because the basic principle was the rule of law. The highest court of the land, the Court of Appeal, had ruled that the LCD should go for a special conference in which constituencies had expressed no confidence in the National Executive Committee. But the National Executive Committee undermined that ruling of the Court of Appeal. That was the, what you may call, the proverbial last straw in the LCD that caused the split.
Re tswile LCD gawana le bona. Re tswile LCD me ba ile ba re tsamaya ka khotso ba tla sala ka khotso.
The leadership of the faction that remained behind, which did not include the leader, because the leader went with the breakaway. The leadership that remained behind had been in conversation with us, not about forming a coalition government, because they expected to win and we expected to win. And it did not become very difficult when we looked at the figures to phone each other and say, why don't we come together and form a government? So it is something that happened on its own. It is something that none of us had pre-planned, and it happened, and we looked at the reality, and also the fact that we had been in some conversation before, and I say some conversation, made it easy for us to reach an agreement, and that agreement clearly needed even a third player, and the BNP became that third player, and we formed a coalition government.
A rose is a rose by any other name. Ntoyelentle intenta dilimme hore na we bisa ka lebitso le feng intle ke so Democratic Congress e leng sona.
Ya leboa ka ho tla mona ka bongata bona bo le tlileng ka bona le gomelletse molaetsa ho lefatshe le bohle ba neng ba ntse bana le pelaelo ka hore na le gotla la puso ya setšhaba ka setšhaba hana keng
ila ka kena dikgethong tseo ke se ke le moetapele wa legotla la puso ya setšhaba ka setšhaba mme ya gare fila dikgethong le tla gopola he ke mo legotla la heso le ileng la fungana fela ditulo tse 26 ka paramenteng e le mabatowa 12
le di dulo tsa gagathane tse 14
me batho ba le ba ritisatsana gore nna nka ha o katla wa tla ho nna BNP nna nka sebetsa tjena le wena ha o katla ho nna BNP gona le LCD ka sebetsa tjena le wena DC le BNP ha le ka la kopana ha le hloke ABC le LCD ka theya mmuso.
All those events culminated in the ruling party not being able to gain an overall clear majority at the polls.
Once it became clear that the LCD had opted to join the ABC and the BNP to form government, and they had declined to form government with us, it was very clear to me that the right thing to do is to hand over power.
After the results had been fully announced, I got a call from the then and Prime Minister, who said, I have been to His Majesty to hand in my resignation. He has refused because he said he has to know who will take over from me. Now, that to me was a big surprise because I was not expecting that kind of phone call, because we had been fighting a very bitter battle with the former Prime Minister during the election campaign, and the rest is history. When we got there, there was a sitting arrangement that was made by the government secretary for us to how we were going to sit and so on. And the government secretary was, of course, in the company of the Chief Justice, who was going to do the swearing-in ceremony and so on. After the swearing-in ceremony, we walked back to our sitting place. And the outgoing Prime Minister said, "You remember I was sitting here?" I said, "Yes." He said, "Now you sit there, and I sit where you were sitting." I said, "No, but that is my seat, and this is your seat." I'm always protesting against something. I don't know why. So I protested a bit there. But he dismissed my protest and said, no. I have to sit here and you have to sit here. Again, symbolically, Mr. Musisi indicated that there had been a change. And this was done in the National Stadium, where all Basotho were, a very large number of Basotho were watching live. And a lot of Basotho were watching through their television screens and so on and so forth. So that symbolic act, to me, marked a new era for Lesotho.
The practicalities of government, that the Prime Minister sits next to His Majesty, and that once I had handed over power to him, I had passed the baton of power to him, handed over the flag and the constitution of Lesotho, the instruments of government to him. I was no longer Prime Minister. So I had no business going back to the seat that I had occupied a few minutes earlier when I was Prime Minister. He was now Prime Minister. And he had taken the oath of office, so he was the one that should sit next to His Majesty.
After the election results were announced and the final counts were done, we saw, and I saw personally, a handover of power from the former Prime Minister to the current Prime Minister in a very public way, and in a very formal but very transparent way.
What Lekgotleng o qetile go tlhatlhoba mokgetho wa mabotho a sesole mo teng ka morago go lebeletsweng gore o tla etsa puo ya pulo ya paramente ya borobedi ya Lesotho.
Mohlomphei tonagolo matona a khabane mohlomphei tonagolo ya ditulong ka jeno ntate motswa hae Thomas Thabane puo ya hae ha amohela lesokwana la puso o ile a re setšhaba se re tshepetse ho se etella pele ka sebopeho sena seo re emeng ka sona ka hona re sepane sa setšhaba Resepane Silisi.
I want my friend Tom to do what I knew he was capable of doing in the past. He is very brave. He thinks well. He's always cautious. But he's not sluggish. He's an action person.
He is clearly an experienced person. But then he has a difficult job of being prime minister in a three-party coalition.
It is really a new environment that we are in, and we need to give it a chance and see. But I think it can definitely go a long way in bringing a sustained stability in the country.
We cannot have a Lesotho that continues to countenance such clear violations of the democratic principle. And if my colleagues and I in the coalition and all other our partners in this game in Lesotho cannot take full cognizance of the fact that we cannot continue at this level, but that we must move to the next level, then Lesotho will always remain as a least developed country. And the only way to move out of that is to completely and fully embrace the democratic ideal.